So not putting in time here, we are going to proceed further in understanding how we can create data extracts. Alright, so as I mentioned, the extracts are where you create a subset of your data source. You can extract a particular data, you can save it as a subset, which will help you in performing and improving your query. So instead of the live, you can simply click on the extract, which will create a Tableau extract for you. Alright, so let me take you to the repository, and in that you will be able to identify in my Tableau repository data sources. You can see that we have a Tableau extract here for world indicators. So what it's done is it has created a subset of the world indicators data source, and it's created, it's disconnected, it's an offline mode, which can allow us to improve the performance. It can be accessed offline as well when you're away, when you're probably traveling, and we can then create an extract where we can keep refreshing it with the original data, and we can then replace it with the content, or we can provide a complete incremental refresh to these. Alright, now extracts can also be created from within our data sets as well once you perform. So let's say, let me go back to our view here, and let's have category in our columns, let's have quantity on our rows. Now even here you have the option of going under the data menu where you can click on the extract data. So whatever you've selected, any kind of performances and any kind of the aggregations that you perform, now this is your data that you perform. Now instead of, even though it's a live connection, you can still go to the data menu here and you can click on create and extract a data, which will create a subset. Alright, which will create a subset for you where you can create this data and you can provide the different fields wherein you can select what you want to filter, whether you want to add a specific filter to your field, whether you want to specify the aggregation data for the visible dimensions. This is where you can select the option for the measures to be aggregated. The default, instead of using the default, what is the kind of aggregation that you want to use. So this can allow you to minimize the size of your file as well and increase your performance. You can click on aggregation and you want to roll up the dates to year, to quarter, to month, you can select on the aggregation. The number of rows that you want to allow in terms of the incremental fetch here, you want to provide the incremental fetch for all rows or just the top particular selected rows. So you can select on that particular option. Once you've specified all these detailings, you can then click on extract, and that's going to save the subsequent file in the location that you have saved in terms of the extract, and it will save up an extract for you, alright? So when you click on extract, it will ask you for a subsequent location of where you want to save it. There is a custom query that we had used. And let's say if we save it on the desktop itself, you can see the save type, which is a .tde, which is a Tableau data extract. And the next time you can start working using these data extracts and you can start performing, where you do not need to then have your custom SQL written in or any other detailing. You can simply use the extract and start working on it. All right, you can actually restrict the size and improve the performance, and you can perform data extracts on these as well. All right. And then again, in the data menu option here, you have the option to replace your particular data source. So let's say you have your option where you want to perform an incremental fetch, then you can replace the data or you can upgrade it. Or for that matter, you can go to this particular table, you can refresh your data with the connection where you have the additional refresh data. You can view your data, you can duplicate it, rename it. We just discussed how we can create the extract data options as well. So that's how you can perform and see and have an extract of your data. So that was using your data extracts. Now, you can also write custom SQL. So we've discussed that. Let me take you back to the presentation slide and have a recap. So here, this is the window that we saw in terms of the extract, where you can add in the qualifications, where you can narrow down your data even more further. You can select an incremental fetch, whether you want it for all the rows or limit the number of rows to be included in that particular extract. Then we also saw that how we could write a custom SQL. We could open it in a legacy connection that helped us to open up a custom SQL window where we can write down the SQL with the exact data that we want to analyze. This can again help us in improving the query performances, where we can write down and provide an optimized query against our data that we want to use. Right? In terms of the supported data sources, a lot of you all had questions, what kind of data sources are supported. Now, Tableau Desktop is supporting the, it determines the support depending on the kind of license that you have purchased, alright. So, only when you have the required license, it will support the different data source types. And you have a personal edition, which provides you and allows you to use the support for a lot of databases. But it is the professional edition that provides you additional database options that you can connect to. So data such as text files, Access files, Excel sheets, and so on, these can be connected through the personal editions. While in terms of a professional edition, the professional license, this is where you can connect other than the personal editions, you can connect to the personal additional databases like your Oracle, SQL, and you can connect to certain more additional connections here, which is supported, 40 plus data connections, which is supported in the professional edition, right? So that's how you can connect to these different connections. Now, also along with that, once you have your server that comes into picture, what a server does is it provides you a Kerberos authentication, which is a supported, trusted authentication that it uses in terms of your single sign-on. Alright, so what it does is in this case is that as you can see, it is a protocol that is provided to trust the authentication between your machines, and that's how it uses a third party network service called as the KDC, the Key Distribution Center, which provides a secure connection between your desktop and the server machines. And this is supported based on the Kerberos authentication. All right, and that's where you can, it handles in, it uses only one user authentication, the permissions and the access control in such cases like the workbooks is going to be now these. The workbooks and extracts will not be handled by Kerberos, but the permissions and access control, those are the things, those are the detailing that Kerberos will be handling in terms of your data connection. Alright, so basically if your Tableau server has a Kerberos enabled on your machine with a valid Active Directory credential, then what Tableau does is it connects to your server and it completely skips the step of authenticating. So in case, let me take you to the environment. You're in the environment, you can see the server option, and in this you have the publish workbook. Now let's say when you want to, you've created your workbook and you want to publish it onto your server. Now this is where it asks you to connect to the server here. It asks you to provide the credentials, and then based on that, it then asks you, once you've connected to, let's say you've connected to your server, it is then going to ask you a sign-on for that particular configuration. Now, if you have a Kerberos environment which is activated, then it's going to skip these basic steps here and it will directly allow you to connect and skip these connection that comes in between. So that is what is Kerberos authentication. Alright, so it's a single sign-on method, and once you have that enabled, then you can make use of these. You need to configure your Tableau server with these Kerberos configurations, all right? So it's a three-way authentication protocol. Now, how this works is a mechanism of mutual authentication between the client and the server is provided with the Kerberos authentication. So when the user logs into the directory, it directly asks for the credentials which are authenticated by Kerberos. And once this is authenticated, a ticket is generated and sent to the user's computer. And then when the user tries to connect to the Tableau server from the desktop or the web browser, the server, the Tableau server authenticates the user and it directly allows us to perform. Now this mechanism is provided before the network connection is opened up between the client and the server. Right? So how does it work in terms of a single sign-on? How does it support it? It supports a single sign-on option wherein you have the server configuration, and in this you have a Foreboss tab where you can define enabling the single sign-on option in terms of the environment where you can connect. Individually, you can connect with a single sign-on to connect to the server from your desktop or the web browser. Alright. In terms of trying to optimizing your query, now how can you optimize your query? Tableau adopts various query optimization techniques to improve the query performance. Alright. So what it does is it provides parallel query where it improves the performance speed of the dashboard by performing and providing a capability of executing a parallel query. So in this case, what happens is it executes more queries at the same time. It is independent queries that start at the same time, and hence we are faster and improves the performance. So this is what Tableau does. It provides the parallel query. Next in, it has the query fusion. In this, what it does is Tableau has the ability to reduce any kind of complex or large number of queries into a fewer simple ones. So that's how it again optimizes your performance. Right, and then it also has external query caching. In this, it quickens up the process of optimizing your data by processing it into a cache. All right, so that it does not need to go and hit in the warehouse every time that you require a particular data. So this is possible with the external query caching. So Tableau adopts these various methods. It also has a data engine vectorization, wherein it has an in-memory analytics column, and it's a faster query which helps in reducing the extract size and creation time. So based on these, that's how it can improve the performance, and that's how it optimizes these techniques, and Tableau handles and takes care of each of these. So it performs a parallel query by its own. It uses a particular query fashion which is short. It does not it shortens up all the queries, the external query caching that it uses, and also provides a data engine vectorization where it makes it even more quicker and faster. Now, in order to quicken the process of your loading of data, what Tableau does is it creates and saves a shadow extract file on its own. All right, what it does is in the repository for you to load your data faster, other than you creating an extract, it takes up the content of a shadow extract in your repository file and it saves it up as a shadow while you're working on the workbook. Alright, and that's where then when you're creating and working based on the legacy, non-legacy Excel or text files or statistical file, it creates a shadow extract file automatically wherever you have your repository. So in case when you're working on something, what it does is in your repository folder, alright, where you have your repository, which is in my documents, in the data sources, you will be able to see that it provides you a particular extract, that is a shadow extract that's been created, and you can see that it creates a shadow extract right there where that you can make use of. All right, in the background. So this is done automatically by Tableau to quicken up the process. This is something that you do not need to handle by default. This the folder, there is a folder that gets created when you have a proper licensed version. Then you will see that in the repository folder you will have a shadow extract folder, and based on that, that is how you will see that at least the first five, at least the top five shadow extracts will be saved with a .ttde extension, and that's how it uses and replaces it, replaces the oldest one. So when you have a licensed version in that case, then that's when you will be able to see this extract folder, and this is when it quickens up the entire process.